I travel throughout the year, so about three times a year I would travel through the States to my NHL teams and work with my athletes there. In the summer months, I get to treat them at home, obviously. So I've been doing hands-on therapy for 21 years. I've worked with all levels, and as you know, Coach said, I have a multidisciplinary clinic in town, and we will be, you'll also get a fascia stretching therapist tomorrow night, and we will be following these camps throughout the summer so that we are accessible to you guys. So what I wanted to talk to you today is about something that we don't even have research for yet, and that's what's happened during COVID. So during the last, let's say, 16 months, for lack of a better time frame, a lot of things have changed within your bodies. And as strength and conditioning coaches, as therapists, as doctors, we really don't have all the pieces to those puzzles in terms of how your body has changed. But there are a few things we know for certain, and that's kind of the things I'm going to talk to you today about. Some of this will be over your heads, but mom and dad will get it in the video part. Okay, so it's important that they listen to this video because it's just important that everybody understands that you guys are different kids now. So one of the main things is that for the first time in history, you guys were stuck in front of a laptop, an iPad, a computer, and there was no recess, there was no gym class, there was no hockey tryouts, there was no basketball camps. And for the most part, you might have done some dribbling in your driveway, or you might have done some sit-ups in your basement, but you guys weren't developed as kids. And to be honest, if your parents, and this isn't, but if everybody followed the rules, you guys would have been played in the street. You would have been shunned to your backyard to play with your siblings, and that would have been the most you got. And because of that, there's pediatricians, and there's doctors, and there's psychologists all over the world starting to figure out right now, what does this mean for our kids' development? And this is why I'm going to talk to you today, because the real boring stuff that the coaches do with you guys this week ends up being the most important pieces. Not the dribbling, not the shooting, not the scrimmaging, but the actual movements and your warm-ups. So here's why. Number one, you've been sitting. And you've been sitting for school, you've been sitting for your homework, you've been sitting for some of your, even some of your sports were still on an iPad or a computer. So for the first time, we have kids that have tight hip flexors, and hamstrings, and low backs, and necks. Normally, we've got a bit of latitude, meaning that we don't worry about kids as they grow, we don't worry about kids as they do sports, because you guys are going to heal and you're going to recover and you're going to get stronger and you guys don't complain. Different post-COVID. Now you guys are sore. Now you guys are stiff. And now you guys are in postural problems, meaning that from sitting like this all day long and then all of a sudden coming to a basketball camp and opening that up, you guys are all predisposed to injuries and soreness that as parents, as coaches, as therapists, we're like, they're 13. No big deal. Now, unfortunately, we have to be aware of those issues because they are going to make it more easy for you guys to sprain an ankle or pull a hamstring. So that's number one. The other thing that ties into that is the fact that most of you, if not all of you, grew. If you guys looked at a picture from March of 2020, I can almost guarantee you don't look the same. Some are leaner, some are thicker, right? Some are taller, but you're different. So we can't treat you the same. So now two things have happened at the same time. You've spent a year plus sitting like this, and in that same time you've grown. So growing means, what happens in growth is that the bones of the body grow, and the muscles and tendons are on stretch, meaning they're pulled tight, which is why your knees hurt, and why at night you guys sometimes have sore legs. Well, partner that with the fact that you sat for class, and you looked and stared at the computer, now what you've got is a real problem with the shortening and the pulling. It's almost like a tug of war fight with your muscles and tendons. Now all of a sudden we're open and we'll have a little bit more freedom, and now you guys are standing, running, jumping, all these things after being growing and sitting for an entire year plus. So the physiology and the anatomy and stuff that we know that your bodies go through with your natural growth spurts, we can't rely on that anymore. So we can't say, oh, your knee hurts, or, you know, put a nice pack on, you'll be fine. The other problem, and this is where the coaches come in, is that normally as you grow, your coordination and your strength and your movement patterns, they get developed with you. Whether you're running in the playground, playing basketball at the end of the street, those patterns and those growth spurts kind of go hand in hand. So everything gets developed at the same momentum, but not since COVID. So in this last year and a bit, you guys have been sitting through your development. You've been doing push-ups in your basement through this development, but you haven't actually been developed. So there's a difference between, yes, you've developed, but you haven't been developed. So now here's the problem with a bit of science and physiology and anatomy, is that we don't know, scientists don't know, pediatricians don't know where your body is actually at. We don't know if your kneecap's the right place, or if your arches are fallen, and what that actually means to developing you as an athlete. So, this is a little bit above your pay grade, but things called muscle spindles and Golgi tendon organs are things that are in your muscles and tendons. And your job is to contract and relax, and to teach you how to move. But you guys haven't moved in a year and a half, so they don't know how to work anymore. So the other thing that we would just assume would work normally are those things. But we can't assume that you have muscle memory anymore. So what muscle memory is that, you know, there used to be a saying where it's like riding a bike. We can't say that anymore. So you may actually not remember how to ride a bike when it comes to your muscles. So now that you've sat and you've recreated other improper patterns, then you've grown without any development, you can't rely on muscle memory because the muscles have no memory. In your growth spurts, you lose those memories. But typically, pre-COVID, you would be learning and adapting to new ones because you would be playing sports, you'd have recess, you'd be in gym class, but you haven't had those things. So we can't rely on those what we call innate things, where your body would just grow and react and you'd be perfectly normal. Unfortunately, we have no groundwork on how your bodies are actually physiologically, anatomically, and physically going to work. This is the first time we've done it in a year and a half. So while you guys are doing these things, and the reason I'm here isn't to give you a physiology lecture, but it's to remind you that the most important piece of this week are the 30 minutes you're going to do after I leave, and the 30 minutes or an hour you're going to do at the end of the day. When you're stretching and doing your warm-up, this is the most critical time to do it, because you're going to learn about yourselves, the coaches are going to watch you move and go, oof, oof, oof. Right? They're going to be able to see where you're tight. You guys don't know how you're supposed to move because you've completely forgotten how to do it. You just don't realize it. Your arches are fallen, you've grown, your hamstrings got tighter, your knees got whatever. Everything's changed. This is the first time, this is the third day, so even in a regular camp, this is the sore day. But you're going to be more sore than you probably would have in 2020. So when you're doing your stretches and when you're doing your warm up, I'm putting this on you guys. Okay? So if you don't want to end up seeing me, it's incredibly important when the coaches are doing something, if you're like, do, and have no idea why you're doing it, and you feel absolutely nothing, so you say, you know, coach, I'm doing this stretch, I think, but I really don't know what I'm feeling, or what should I be feeling. Make sure that you take the time to do the stretches, do your warm-ups, and do your cool-downs, and most importantly, relearn those movement patterns for basketball, because you have nothing to go from. Normally there is some sort of a manual pattern or, you know, something that you can rely on. You don't have it anymore. So it's really, really important when you're stretching, or the reverse. You do this stretch, you're like, oh my god, I'm like a 10 out of 10 for pain. They need to know that because you just might be standing properly. Maybe they have to modify that stretch because you went through roof 6 inches since March of 2020, and yeah, that stretch is a little more painful. They can give you modifications for it if they know it, right? If you guys are sore, you should get something every day, okay? There's a lot of things you can do at home, but again, you have to relay that information to your parents or to your coaches. Normally, I wouldn't come to the same group and tell you guys all this stuff, because you can just rely on the fact that you're young and you'll get over it. We don't have that anymore. We don't know that those parameters, those guidelines are already. We're going to get them back. Probably in about 6 months, we're going to know what your bodies are going to go through and how quickly they regain that muscle memory, but we don't know it right now. So we're going to expect that your sorenesses are going to be a little bit worse, come on a little bit faster, and last a little bit longer. And if we know that, then we can adjust everything from your 9 o'clock warm up to your 4:30 cool down. That can be adjusted. We're going to learn from you, and you guys are going to learn from us, and that's how we're going to get through this, so that we keep you guys as safe as possible. 80% of sports injuries happen because you've done too much too fast. And again, we don't have the camera by all the information, so the only way these guys are going to know that is you have to tell them. It's not listening out, it's not complaining. We might have thought of that maybe 2 years ago, and just say, you know what, too bad, you're going to have to be able to keep doing your laps. Now we just need to know, because there's probably a correction. You might not be in the right shoes. Your shoes might be too small. Your hamstrings might be too tight. Those are all corrections we can make. And if the coaches don't know the answer, they'll contact one of us and we'll know the answer. Yo? Any questions?
Are we doing stretches?
Yep. Are you doing stretches?
Are we going to do stretches?
Yep, you're going to do your warm up as soon as I stop gapping. Okay? Very good question. So you can go into stores now. If you and your parents don't feel comfortable with that, I can have a tape measure here tomorrow so you can actually measure your 20
feet.
Yeah. So here's the other problem starting with COVID, right? So my runners, especially my hockey players, couldn't go into a store to buy running shoes, so a lot of people had to buy shoes online, not having any idea what foot size they are anymore, or what the shoe cleaning was going to feel like. So that's actually a really good question, and it is a problem, but we can correct it. Okay, so those let me know if you guys need to measure. Okay?
You just want to see the US or Canada?
Most of my NHL players are Canadians, but they play in the US. Yeah. Any other questions? Okay, how about the coaches? Any questions?
No, you made some really good points, so I'm going to watch this video. This is really, really good. So we're very fortunate here. We are going to go through our typical dynamic warm-up. It's going to be maybe even a little longer today. We're going to add a few movements in. And these athletic therapists are going to kind of watch you guys go through it. And they're going to maybe recognize something that can make you a better athlete, okay, or prevent something from happening.
Well, actually, I have one more thing to add to it. Eyesight. Here's the other thing that they have no parameters for. So normally in your day, you would be doing your work up close, but then you'd be looking at a smart board that was far away. So your eyes would adjust to near and far. And typically in your age, if you're not nearsighted or farsighted, you're still to develop. The other research I read the other day is that the majority of the kids now can see clear, but they're having trouble seeing far. So in your drills, if you're noticing any of that, just let somebody know. The really easy correction is if you're having trouble focusing, take your eyes up, look at something that's far away, blink 20 times, and let the eyes refocus. Especially drills and balls coming at your head.
There's a lens in your eye, it's like this clear little marble, and it relaxes when we look at like a horizon far away. So when we're looking close, our eyes, it's like a bicep, our muscle constantly flexes. Remember we talked about the cramping yesterday and how much that hurt? That's what's happening kind of in these eye muscles. So we need to relax. I actually do these exercises 3 times a week, near, medium, and far, because I do have bad eyesight, so I'm trying to see what I do have.
So yeah, if something's blurry for a second, just look up and then look back down. Okay? It is something you guys are going through because of those computer screens. Good question? Oh, yeah, so Mike is going to come back tomorrow. These guys are going to stay a little bit longer and watch you. So if you have any questions or anything, we're going to start kind of looking at your bodies and seeing how they're moving. And then that information is going to go to the coaches, and they're going to use that over the upcoming weeks to help you guys through this development process that is unique and unique to everybody. Deal? Okay? And then again, Mike's tomorrow, and if anybody has any questions, either tell coach and he'll come through me, or I'll come back. Okay?
Awesome.
All right, guys, enjoy the day.
Thank you so much.
Welcome.